back on, right? You couldn't avoid it. So that's where the hate crime is back coming in.
नाज़रीन, आज दिल अपने पाकिस्तान के साथ इंतखाब अहमद यहाँ पे ट्रिनिटी बैप्टिस्ट चर्च जो कि वैंकूवर में है ग्रैनविल रोड पे, और यहाँ पे एक मैंने साइन देखा है और वो साइन है वीपिंग विद कैनेडियन मुस्लिम्स।
नाज़रीन, दिल अपना पाकिस्तान के साथ इंतखाब अहमद आज आपसे मुखातिब है नए प्रोग्राम के साथ, जिसमें कुछ दुनिया की बदलती हुई सूरत हाल और जिसमें इमरान खान, इस्लामोफोबिया और कम्युनिटी की इन्वॉल्वमेंट के बारे में और पहली जुलाई के प्रोग्राम्स इनके बारे में बात होगी। नाज़रीन, इमरान खान ने जिस तरह से फॉरेन मीडिया को एक इंटरव्यू देते हुए कहा है कि एब्सोल्युटली नॉट टू वर्ड्स, लेकिन मेरी नज़र में इसी तरह ये जो फॉरेन मीडिया है ये इस ख़ास तौर पे अमेरिका की जो फॉरेन पॉलिसी है वो डिक्टेट करता है, और इस यही फॉरेन पॉलिसी अगर वो क्या कहते हैं बैकडोर से नहीं होती तो फिर ये मीडिया के थ्रू करते हैं, और हमारे मुस्लिम मुल्कों में ख़ास तौर पे उनके लीडरान के साथ यही किया है, फिर वो बैड गाय के तौर पर डिक्लेयर कर दिए जाते हैं। तो पाकिस्तान के लोगों को बिल्कुल इमरान खान को सपोर्ट करना चाहिए गवर्नमेंट लेवल तक, और हर लेवल तक पाकिस्तानियों को सपोर्ट करना चाहिए बिल्कुल एक जान होकर। और ये जो पीडीएम टाइप लोग हैं या जो लंडे के लिबरल्स हैं इन पर कोई भी तवज्जो ना दें। देखते रहिए वैंकूवर की जान, दिल अपना पाकिस्तान।
My name is Corporal Anthony Statham. I'm a RCMP officer. I'm in charge of the Metro Hate Crime Team. I'm here today with Constable Shiraz Adib from Metro Vancouver Transit Police. And upstairs is my colleague, Sergeant Andrea Sawki from National Security Community Operations City Sisters. Thank you so much for having us today to speak in Juma. It's very humbling. I haven't been to Surrey Jammy in a couple of years. The last time I came, we were bringing a message from our hate crime team to just stress the importance of reporting anything that's suspicious or anything that could be a threat to the community to your local police department. The only emergency, call 911 if something has happened. Past or there's no immediate threat, to just call the non-emergency number for the police department.
Is the MMA
it's true, it's never too late to report.
It's never too late to you can report any crimes, never hesitate, police is in your sight, the government in your sight, and never shy. Because no crime is small, or no crime is small. So any crime happened, even 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 4 years ago, you have to report. If we not report, if we shy off, then police cannot help us. So more reporting, that's not helping.
And it's true, thank you. That is true. It's never too late to report. It's not as though something that happened 2 years ago wouldn't be rejected by the police in any sense. Given what happened in London last week, the tragic attack where 4 members of the family died, and by the way, it doesn't have a family anymore. Just coming here to say, report everything suspicious to see seems kind of inadequate. So I'm also here to say that from the RCMP standpoint, as Canada's National Police Force, we're committed to working with our law enforcement partners to make sure that no stone is left unturned as far as identifying people who could be a threat to the community, and maybe especially the sisters who are really visible in the community wearing hijabs. And we're essentially here to try and do everything we can to keep everybody safe. That's all I have to say. Thank you very much for your time. On the outside, if anyone wants to talk or ask questions, I'm going to turn it over to.
responsible for us to meet with Metro Vancouver Transit Police. Same messages, and on the transit system, anything's happening, please call 911, the closest police officer will come to you, whether it's transit or RCMP or DPD. If it's not safe for you, pick up the phone and call because the aggressor is too close to you. Text us. We have a text message reporting system, 877777. 8 followed by 57. Not an easy phone number to remember. I have cards outside on the table. Please take them. Take them to your family, take them to your sisters. Let them program it into the phone. So if in case they ever do need to call us or text us, they have the phone number saved. At Transit Police, a lot of work gets done behind the scenes by police departments that not everyone's aware of. At Transit Police, we increase patrols during JOA time. We go from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. There's been increased people wearing traditional clothing, hijabs, on the transit system going to and from JOMA. So I created a bulletin, we disseminating it amongst patrol, and that way our members are aware that you guys can be out there. Not only can we try to keep you safe, and let you feel safe. If you see the presence, you might feel safer. So we'll be outside if you have any questions, please.
Thank you very much,
Sundays at 3:30 p.m., Dil Apna Pakistan brings you Canadians with roots in Pakistan and features community information and entertainment.
Nazreen, Dil Apna Pakistan ke saath Intikhab Ahmed, aaj Fleetwood Park mein, Fleetwood Park jo Saray ke khoobsurat tareen parkon mein ek park hai. और कोविड रिस्ट्रिक्शन जो हैं वो आज जून 15 को उठ चुकी हैं और उसके साथ साथ जो भी है प्रोटोकॉल कोविड रिस्ट्रिक्शन का वो फॉलो करें और जुलाई 1 कनाडा डे की पेश की मुबारकबाद पाकिस्तानी कम्युनिटी एसोसिएशन जो कि हमेशा से अपने नाज़रीन को अपने चाहने वालों को अपने लोगों को एंटरटेन भी करते हैं उनके लिए पिकनिक का इंतज़ाम किया है इस साल और जुलाई 1 को 2 बजे फ्लीटवुड पार्क में यहाँ पे होगा. इसकी डिटेल के लिए देखते रहिए वैंकूवर की जान दिल अपना पाकिस्तान. जी नाज़रीन ग्रीन ग्रास के साथ साथ यहाँ पे वॉकवेज इतने खूबसूरत बने हुए हैं, लोग अपने कुत्ते भी वॉक करवा रहे हैं. यहाँ पे ये लिब्रेंस सर्कल जो है ये बनाया गया है और इसकी लिब्रेंस सर्कल जो है हिस्ट्री ऑफ लिब्रेंस इज एन एंशिएंट पैटर्न फाउंड इन कल्चर्स अराउंड द वर्ल्ड इन मैनी डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स. तो आप इसे गूगल करें और देखें. ये फ्लीटवुड गार्डन में लिब्रेंस सर्कल बनाया हुआ है. लिब्रेंस सर्कल के पास ये पिकनिक होगी कनाडा डे की जुलाई 1 को. जी नाज़रीन दिल अपना पाकिस्तान के साथ इंतखाब अहमद आज सरे मस्जिद में जुमे की नमाज के बाद यहाँ पे काफ़ी लोग आए हुए हैं जिनमें ट्रांजिट पुलिस के कारपोल हनीफ भी हैं और उनके साथ हम दूसरा इंटरव्यू करेंगे. RCMP BC के जो चीफ हैं वो यहाँ पे हैं. वो हेट क्राइम के बारे में बात करेंगे. आइए 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 हम इनसे बात करते हैं. नाज़रीन दिल अपना पाकिस्तान के साथ इंतखाब अहमद आज सरे मस्जिद में अगेन मैं इन दोनों का इंटरव्यू लेना चाह रहा हूँ जो कि एंथोनी हैं और ये एंथोनी स्टैथम कॉर्पोरल हैं सरे BC RCMP के और मेरे साथ एम्ब्रिया हैं और एम्ब्रिया जो हैं वो सार्जेंट हैं. तो आई टॉक स्टार्ट विद एम्ब्रिया बिकॉज शी वॉज not take an interview before. So Ambria, you tell me about how you feel like that when somebody attacks on innocent people and how you are going to protect it.
Well, obviously it's something it's awful. It's public safety is the reason I got into policing is because I care about my community and want to make sure that I can do my best to help protect it. And part of the way that we can protect it is making sure that we have good relationships with our community members. And so they know that they can come and talk to us and so that we can build trust and to try and make sure that as concerns arise and as people are concerned, that we can try and help them, and that we can try and educate, and that we can try and protect ahead of time.
Right, and sometimes the women are even shy to report. Sometimes happens something, somebody passerby, he commented very bad, and she's scared to tell or speak out. How you can encourage those victims to come out and say something about it?
Just by encouraging at this point, because some of that, it takes a lot of courage to come forward, especially when you have been a victim. But part of the way that we can do our job better is when we know. It's very difficult for us to help and to find resources and support for victims if we don't know that they're there. And so the best way that we can do that is to encourage them to come forward. And our commitment is that we are working to do our best to help them.
Very good. And thank you very much. And now I have Anthony again with me. Anthony, again, how you feel like the contribution of the community right now at this moment? What are your feeling? People are cooperating with you?
Well, absolutely. I mean, I think that there's a lot of appetite in the community in Surrey, or just in BC in general, to want to find solutions to making people safer. You know, that doesn't necessarily have to be more police on the streets. It really boils down to making sure that first there's good communication between the community and the police, and then there's good communication within the police as well, that we're all working together as law enforcement partners to make sure that we're doing the best job that we can to keep everybody safe.
Very good. I appreciate the efforts of the RCMP and the community. Thank you very much. जी नाज़रीन दिल अपना पाकिस्तान के साथ इंतखाब अहमद सरे मस्जिद में आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू अ क्विक क्वेश्चन अबाउट हाउ वी कैन व्हाट यू हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन इनसाइड बट what is the quickest response we can do or anybody who has been subject to hate crime?
So the quickest response is to call 911. Obviously, if somebody feels threatened or sees a threat to somebody else and the threat's ongoing, that's the quickest way. If it feels like nobody's in danger, in any sort of imminent danger, then the best thing to do is to call the non-emergency number for the local police department.
Very good, non-emergency number. Regarding transit police, I have Hanif with me. Could you please, Constable Hanif, say something about transit customers?
My recommendation is to attend safety seminars. We'll be conducting safety seminars with the committee here about safety on transit, and jurisdictional police departments offer safety seminars. And there's little tips on how to be safe, and when you're being safe, you'll feel safe. Incidents get a lot of coverage by the media, but in general, the situations are not as many as the media covers.
Okay.
The coverage makes it seem as if. So you're still safe out there, generally speaking.
Okay.
It's whether you feel safe or not that matters.
Yeah. Yeah. Feel protected. We have, as you said, the media is mentioning. Yeah. I have with me Khalid Chauhan, is the president of Pakistan Community Association. Pakistani, could you say something quickly?
Yeah, thank you very much, Intakaba, for giving me the opportunity to say something. And we are very confident, we are very honored by these officers being here and coordinating with us and taking our concerns and making some decision and educating people, and also letting us know how to deal with the situation if any emergency happens. But this is like multi-dimensional effect. We also need some immediate assets. We also need to work in the society and to educate people about the discrimination and other phenomena available.
So very good. Khalid Chauhan, you said the right thing. We have to work together as a community and society. Thank you very much, Mr. Asal Gondal Saab. You want to say something about...
about you have organized this meeting here.
Yes, Brother Intikhab, as BCMA have always a concern that we are working for the community of the BC. And if the BC community is not safe, we definitely have biggest concern. And BCMA, through all level of the management and authorities, we are working with them that the community here in Canada, especially in the BC Muslim community, feel really unsecured with this verbal and physical abuses every day, discrimination, Islamic phobia, and the rising attack on the Muslim communities. And we will try our best to educate our community using all the level of the authorities to bring them here and make sure that our Muslim community are safe in the BC. This is the prime job of BCMA.
Yeah, thank you very much, Asad Sahib. I have with me Rahat Rao. Rahat Rao is also president of
Muslim Advocacy.
Yeah. So, would you say a few words about it? And
we are very pleased. The police is taking a lot of safety measure, and they came today over masjid here to educate people. But I also have a message for being a president of Canadian Muslim Advocacy International for all Canadian Muslims. We are safe here. This is one incident happened. That doesn't mean we get scared and we stay home. You do whatever you have to do and go out for your daily routine. But just watch out outside. Don't, you know, whenever you traveling nighttime, especially the woman, don't go alone and try to have a cell phone all the time with you. And anything you feel not safe, call right away. Don't shy to call police or any help. And even the next person sitting to them, ask them.
जी नाज़रीन, दिल अपना पाकिस्तान के साथ इंतखाब अहमद आज सरे मस्जिद में आए हुए थे और यहाँ पे आपने यहाँ पे देखा कि कम्युनिटी ने किस तरह से ऑर्गेनाइज़ किया अपने आप को. मस्जिद में बहुत अच्छी तरह से नमाज़ों का सेशन हुआ. उसके बाद आरसीएमपी के बीसी आरसीएमपी की डिटैचमेंट के जो सीनियर थे वो यहाँ पे थे. ट्रांजिट पुलिस के थे ये लोग. यहाँ पे मेरे साथ राहत राव भी हैं. राहत राव के साथ कनेडियन मुस्लिम एडवोकेसी के पाकिस्तानी कनेडियन कम्युनिटी एसोसिएशन के हमारे खालिद चौहान साहब थे और असद गोंदल साहब थे. माशाल्लाह बहुत लोगों ने यहाँ पे पार्टिसिपेट किया. हम आपकी इनके अंदर की जो वो एक सेशन हुआ है हम उसको दिखाएंगे. देखते रहिए वैंकूवर की जान. दिल अपना पाकिस्तान.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. अस्सलाम
वालेकुम. माय नेम इज प्रोफेसर स्टीफन. आई एम अ आरसीपी ऑफिसर इन चार्ज ऑफ द नेशनल एपेक टीम. आई एम हियर टुडे विद हॉस्पिटल सरासी फ्रॉम अटरेंट द ट्रांसपोर्ट पुलिस एंड अपस्टेयर्स माय कॉलीग सर्जेंट एंड्रे सॉफी फ्रॉम नेशनल सिक्योरिटी. Thank you so much for having us today to speak in Juma. It's very humbling. I haven't been to Surrey Jammie in a couple of years. The last time I came, we were bringing a message from our hate crime team to just stress the importance of reporting anything that's suspicious or anything that could be a threat to the community to your local police department. You know, an emergency, call 911 if something has happened and in the past or you know, there's no immediate threat, to just call the non-emergency number for the police department.
Is the end of the week
It's true, it's never too late to report.
It's never too late to report any crimes. Never hesitate. Police is in your side, the government in your side, and never shy, because no crime is small or no crime is small. So any crime happened, even 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 4 years ago, you have to report. If we not report, if we shy off, then police cannot help us. So more reporting, that's not helpful.
And it's true. Thank you. That is true. It's never too late to report. It's not as though something that happened 2 years ago wouldn't be rejected by the police in any sense. Given what happened in London last week, the tragic attack where four members of the family died, and the way it doesn't have a family anymore. You know, just coming here to say, report everything suspicious to see seems kind of inadequate. So I'm also here to say that from the RCMP standpoint, as Canada's National Police Force, we're committed to working with our law enforcement partners to make sure that no stone is left unturned as far as identifying people who could be a threat to the community, maybe especially the sisters who are really visible in the community wearing hijabs. And we're essentially here to try and do everything that we can to keep everybody safe. That's all I have to say. Thank you very much for your time. If you have a side, if anyone wants to talk or ask questions, I'm going to turn it over to Provost Strauss.
I'm Constable Sharaz Amin with Metro Vancouver Transit Police. Same message as Anthony. On the transit system, if anything's happening, please call 911, the closest police officer will come to you, whether it's transit or RCMP or DPD. If it's not safe for you to pick up the phone and call because the aggressor is too close to you, text us. We have a text message reporting system, 877777. 8 followed by 57. Not an easy phone number to remember. I have cards outside on the table. Please take them to your family, take them to your sisters. Let them program it into the phone. So if in case they ever do need to call us or text us, they have the phone number saved. At Transit Police, a lot of work gets done behind the scenes by police departments that not everyone's aware of. At Transit Police, we increase patrols during JOA time. We go from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. There's been an increase in people wearing traditional clothing, hijabs, on the transit system going to and from Juma. So I created a bulletin to disseminate it amongst patrol, and that way our members are aware that you guys can be out there. Not only can we try to keep you safe, but let you feel safe. If you see the presence, you might feel safer. So that's like my plan. We'll be outside if you have any questions.
नाज़रीन दिल अपना पाकिस्तान के साथ इंतखाब अहमद आज वैंकूवर में ग्रैनविल आइलैंड से दिल अपना पाकिस्तान का एक शो कर रहे हैं। वैंकूवर की जान दिल अपना पाकिस्तान आज रियल वैंकूवर में बैठे हुए हैं और यहाँ का प्रोग्राम आपसे कर रहे हैं। तो नाज़रीन, दुनिया के बदलते हुए हालात और उसमें आती हुई तब्दीलियाँ, वो जब तक हम अपने पाँव पे खुद खड़े नहीं होंगे तो उस वक़्त तक उन तब्दीलियों को हम फेस नहीं कर सकते। जी नाज़रीन, इकरा खालिद जो लिबरल पार्टी की एमपी हैं टोरंटो से, जी इकरा खालिद ने प्राइवेट मेंबर्स बिल पेश किया और वो कैनेडियन पार्लियामेंट में पास भी हो गया है। अब उसकी अगली अप्रूवल होगी। आप इकरा खालिद ने जो इस्लामोफोबिया के बारे में जो बिल पेश किया वो एक बहुत बड़ी काविश है मुसलमानों की कनाडा में, और जो कि हम उसकी ताबीर कुछ इस तरह से देख रहे हैं कि अभी मैं एक चर्च के पास से गुज़र रहा था तो वहाँ पे एक बहुत अच्छी राइटिंग लिखी हुई थी, वी वीप विद कनेडियन मुस्लिम्स। ये देख कर मुझे एहसास होने लगा कि हम वाकई कनाडा के नंबर वन सिटीज़न हैं। हमें कनाडा के नंबर वन सिटीज़न होने के लिए बहुत बड़ी कुर्बानियां देनी पड़ी। नाज़रीन, वो कुर्बानियां जिसमें एक पूरी फैमिली की तीन जनरेशन जो है ख़त्म हो गई, और उससे पहले क्यूबेक मस्जिद पे अटैक हुआ और इंडिविजुअल अटैक हुआ, जैसे जस्टिन ट्रूडो ने कहा कि अगर एडमिंटन में किसी औरत के चेहरे से सर से हिजाब उतारा जाता है उसमें क्यूबेक में रिलीजियस सिंबल्स पे पाबंदी लगाई जाती है, ये इस तरह की जो मेंटेलिटी है हमें उसे ख़त्म करना होगा। उसमें ख़त्म करने के लिए हमें गवर्नमेंट का साथ देना होगा। अपने एमपीज को कहें, और हमारे एमपीज जो हैं यहाँ पे वो हमारे पास वोट लेने तो आते हैं, लेकिन वो हमारी आवाज़ को किस हद तक आगे पहुंचाते हैं ऐवानों में, यहाँ के कनाडा के ऐवानों में उसका हमें ज़रूर उनसे पूछना चाहिए। मोहम्मद यासीन जो कि अल्बर्टा में एमएलए हैं, उन्होंने अपने प्रीमियर को जेसन कैनी को ये मजबूर किया कि वो इस पे बयान दें जो जो कि टोरंटो में एक मुस्लिम फैमिली के साथ हुआ।
The family that was attacked believed, like my family, the family that was attacked was going on an evening walk like I do with my family every evening. As we grieve with our brothers and sisters, please know that we will get through this because hate and division must never win. Prejudice and racism and hatred are disgrace and a sickness of the heart. All Canadians should feel safe in their communities, and they also have the right to feel safe walking down the street. Our society and everyone in it must work together to combat racism and religious intolerance, because it will not go away on its own. It is deeply rooted and must be actively condemned by everyone. We need to do better. We need to be better, and we need to do better. The Muslim friends, I stand with you, and I will continue to fight against Islamophobia and racism in this country and beyond. The young boy, the family, the community, and the country are in my heart. May God bless.
Communities which are in less numbers, but they are human beings, like Muslims, like other Canadians. So I will urge our people to do this. Stay together, like this church has put it. So stay together with Muslims and...